Hey there, I'm your host, Princess Elmore, and welcome back to another episode of Harlequin Books and Cooks. In each episode, I guide a popular romance novelist through a recipe that I personally love, while we chat about their careers and the books they love to write. And today we have joining us is USA Today Publishers Weekly best-selling author, Sheila Roberts. And we're gonna whip up a delicious baked shrimp and broccoli and chat about her passion for writing and music. You don't wanna miss it, so stick around. Known for two popular series, Life in Icicle Falls and Moonlight Harbor, she's written nearly 30 titles, and she is a USA Today best-selling author of romance novels and women's fiction. Sheila Roberts, it's such a pleasure to have you with us today. How are you doing?
I am doing great. I have got my spoon. I've got my ingredients. I am ready to cook.
Well, that is awesome. So, Sheila, this is a recipe that is very popular with my circles of friends. It is a delicious baked shrimp and broccoli. Sounds good?
Sounds great.
Awesome. And for those of you that are at home, there's a link below for the full recipe. You can follow along as well. Miss Sheila, let's get started with the prep. Here we go. We're going to take our bowl of shrimp. It's very easy. And the first thing we're going to do, we're going to go ahead and add all of our dry seasonings and our herbs. The only thing that we will not add at this time will be our parsley, okay? So we're going to go ahead and add in 1 to 2 teaspoons of each dry seasoning. Now, Ms. Sheila, I do not measure my seasoning because I normally season to taste. But Sheila, for you, is 1 to 2 teaspoons of our dry seasonings, and also for those of you at home as well. You ready?
Yes, I am.
And then we're going to add in a little onion powder as well. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and put in my 2 tablespoons of minced garlic. How are we doing over there, Miss Sheila?
I'm good. I've got my garlic in so far and all my dry ingredients.
Perfect. And we got one more thing I want to add in, but before we do that, let's go ahead and stir in our seasonings with the shrimp. All right, so we've given it a good stir. I just wanted to mix in some of the seasonings before we add in the olive oil. Okay. And we're going to go ahead and add in 2 tablespoons of the olive oil. Ready? And I got my little spoon here. So you have your olive oil into your bowl with your shrimp. Mm-hmm. So what we're doing now is we're going to just give it a stir, make sure everything is well blended, and we're going to sit this to the side for about 5 minutes just to let it have a mild marinade.
Cilantro goes in now also, Princess?
Ooh, yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. We can go ahead and put in our cilantro. So let's go ahead and put in our cilantro.
Very good. Yummy.
I want to ask you, what are some stuff that you like to cook for your family?
Wow. Well, you know, I love to eat. So if you're going to eat, you have to cook. So I have a few favorite things. I am a big lover of really old-fashioned cooking, like chicken pot pie, that kind of thing. And dessert. Well, dessert is my favorite recipe. I always say sugar is my drug of choice. Love it. So any kind of pastry or pie. My mama taught me how to make the world's best flaky pie crust. So I love doing that. And my mom always said, you know, leave a good taste in their mouths. Whatever you make for dinner, if they don't like it, as long as they have dessert, they'll be happy. Mm-hmm.
Well, I can already tell that you definitely enjoy cooking and baking like myself, because I absolutely love it. We have our shrimp. And the only other things that we need to do now is prepare it to go in the oven. We're going to just lay 1 piece of our foil down on the top of our cookie sheet.
Okay.
And we want to take about 8 to 10 pieces of our shrimp and lay it on either side. I normally lay mine on the left. And we're going to place our broccoli long ways alongside in our foil.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. One more.
I'm glad you count, Miss Sheila, because I don't even count. I just kind of like guess. Hopefully I got probably like 10, 8 or 10 on there. We're going to add as much broccoli as you want on the side of your shrimp.
Okay, I think I'm good. I'm good. How does this look, Princess? Can you see?
Oh, my God. Delicious. It looks good.
All right.
You're doing amazing. I'm so excited. You're doing really good. Okay, so what we're doing here, we're going to go ahead and take a half of a lemon, Miss Sheila, and we're going to go ahead and sprinkle some of the lemon juice on top of our shrimp and also on top of our broccoli. Like so. We're just going to squeeze it across. And so the last thing we need to add now, Sheila, is basically our butter, our slices of butter. Because what's going to happen is when this is cooking in the oven, it's basically going to marinate all of the seasonings together with the juices. So you're going to have, these are pretty juicy once they come out of the oven. But when we get to that point, we'll go and proceed on how we can handle all the juice there. And then, Miss Sheila, all we're going to do is fold our ends very tightly to make sure that we can keep majority of the juices from spilling out on us. So just want to make sure it's kind of tight on each.
Wrapping a little Christmas present here.
Yes, ma'am. That's exactly what we're doing.
All right.
And it should look like so. Looks good?
Yay, I think so.
Yes, ma'am. So we're going to go ahead and just lay that on our pan right there. And then we're going to go ahead and get another piece of foil. Now, I know that you have been on this journey of writing books for a while, but it was not your first love. I know that you were also a dedicated songwriter, correct?
I was always either writing little stories or little songs, and I did want to be a songwriter. I worked my way through college as a singing waitress at a singing company. I can sing Happy Birthday to the best of them. And then I was in a band. I did all kinds of goofy stuff. And the songwriting thing, though, I just was not meant to be my path.
Wow, you know what? And I was going to ask you about that too. Was singing also a part of your songwriting as well? Are you still writing songs today?
I am. It's very fun. I've had a couple of cuts on some different CDs. It's been very fun. But primarily, I am just sticking with the writing. That was kind of the thing that you kind of go with what's working, don't you? And that turned out to be what was working. So the writing is my main creative outlet, which I love. I love being a writer, and I love writing for Harlequin. Harlequin is my happy ever after place. And I love what I do, and I'm not sure that everybody can say that about what they do for a living, but I'm happy to be able to say that I really love what I do for a living. It's very fun.
Absolutely. I definitely agree that when you're doing something that you really love and passionate about, that's all that matters. So, Sheila, I know you live in the West Coast, right? And is where you live an inspiration for anything that you use, like in your books today, like, say, for an example, Moonlight Harbor. Is that an inspiration of set the atmosphere for your books that you have written?
Life's good at the beach, right? And Moonlight Harbor, my main character, her name is Jenna Jones, the poor thing. She got a divorce for her 40th birthday, and she has been struggling along managing a little place called the Driftwood Inn and paying spousal support to her husband, who's an artiste, which means he doesn't make any money. And so she's been struggling along, and Jenna is finally going to get her love life straightened out. So readers are going to either be Team Brody or Team Seth, and they have been weighing in all along on this series. cues. So I'm excited. It's going to be a fun book. And again, I love setting books at the beach because for most people, it's their happy place. I mean, we all love to go to the beach, right?
Yes. Absolutely. Absolutely. And I definitely love the beach. Love the beach. So Ms. Sheila, anybody that knows your work and follow your work, they know that you have a significant thing about female friendships in your work, in your books. Why do you think it's so important for you to have that relationship of free female friendships in a lot of your novels?
Well, you know, women are very communal. We are team players. We are very loyal. And I'm sure you have women friendships that just mean so much to you. And mine do too. And I think supporting each other as women is really important. And I like to be able to celebrate that in my books.
Absolutely. I totally agree because I am reading your latest novel now. And let me just say this before I even tell the title. We want to go ahead and put this in the oven first. But the relationship you have between Jenna and Courtney is amazing.
I got so busy talking. I don't think I would do multitasker. If I could, I'd squirt it through the foil, you know. But it's I would, because I think I do this so much. It's always an issue. One time I was making baking powder biscuits. I had a girlfriend. I was young. We were living in Germany. And I was making these baking powder biscuits. And I wound up, instead of putting in a teaspoon of salt, because I was talking, I put in a tablespoon of salt. And, you know, they were gorgeous. Beautiful golden brown. And we had company coming. And the poor little guy that first bit into was like, you know, he didn't know what to do, where to look. And then I bit and went, oh, my gosh. So, well, that's life in the kitchen of Sheila Crocker. Anyway, I'm ready to go.
We want to make sure that our oven is on 425. And the only thing about these packets, let me put this on here real quick, is they don't take long to cook at all. We're going to put this in the oven for 20 minutes. All right, Ms. Sheila, we have our packets in the oven. We want to make sure that we set our timer for 20 minutes. And we are all set. Are you good over there?
We are good. Wow, I can just already smell it.
You've been on this journey for so long with writing and songwriting. What advice do you have for people that are maybe it's a young writer that's basically getting started, even a songwriter or a writer of novels and books? What advice can you give them to serve them in the right direction to be as successful as you are now?
I think one of the most important, well, a couple of things. One of the most important things is be patient. You are not going to necessarily become a star overnight. And you want to get your twinkle on. You want to improve your craft. You want to be good enough. So when that spotlight is ready to hit you, you are ready to shine. So I encourage writers to check books out from the library, buy books from your local bookstore, research on how to be a good writer, read other writers and see what they do that you like. It really is a matter of learning your craft. And that doesn't always happen overnight. So, you know, learn your craft, be patient, and little star, your time to twinkle will come.
Absolutely. I definitely agree. And that's great advice to so many people out there. So can you tell me, how was it when you first wrote your very first best-selling novel? How did it feel? What were your feelings at that time?
Best-selling. Well, that is something that we all as authors strive for, because that means the readers are liking what we're doing. And that is a thrill. But I'm going to say one of the biggest thrills I ever had was just when my first novel got published. I was like, oh, it was so exciting to see that dream come true. And firsts are important, aren't they? First kiss, first love, first book, first time hitting the bestseller list. Those are all milestones that are really important to celebrate. And I'm about having parties and celebrating. So anytime I have any kind of success, I am out there celebrating it, because I think that's important. So chocolate happens to be my favorite thing to celebrate with. So chocolate and some success, and I'm a happy camper.
Ms. Sheila, you have full recipes in your books, on your websites. What was your inspiration behind that?
Well, I have recipes in most of my books, and I just think it's nice to give the reader a little bonus. And most of us who are readers also like to cook and be creative in the kitchen. So that's a little extra gift I like to give to my readers. And you'll find a lot of recipes in both the Icicle Falls books and in some of the Moonlight Harbor books as well.
So, Ms. Sheila, I have been waiting for this moment to ask you about your latest novel, Sunset on Moonlight Beach. Please share about your latest novel.
Well, I am excited about that one because, again, my little main character, Jenna Jones, is going to finally get her love life sorted out. And that's always exciting when you can get to the happy ending there. Readers have been waiting for a while for that one. And not only Jenna is going to have her story being told, we have some other characters in there who have been waiting for their happy endings as well. And so they're going to get those. And I'm a big believer in happy endings. Especially with everything we've gone through in the last year and a half, I don't want somebody to shut my book, throw it across the wall, and burst into tears. I just want them to have a smile on their face and come away encouraged.
I'm so glad you said that, because I love happy endings too. And I mean, you didn't give anything away, but now I'm actually so looking forward to the end of this book. A lot of times when I read different women's fiction books, it's something that I have been through. Was that something that you was an inspiration to you in your women's fiction books, or something that you may have went through in the past or anything like that?
Well, one of my, the book that was out before this, Beach Side Beginnings, this is one that was inspired by women that I knew. A friend who got out of an abusive relationship. I have a very good friend who works in an abused women's shelter and works with helping women hit restart on their life. And I really wanted to point out in this book, my main character has gotten out of an abusive relationship. She's hitting restart on her life. So are some of the other characters in the book. And I just wanted to make the point that it is never too late to hit restart. You do not have to stay stuck in the mud. You can get out, you can make something of yourself, and you can find someone who will treat you with the love and respect that you deserve. And I think that's one thing that romance novels really celebrate. It's the fact that our men in these novels appreciate us. They're strong, but they're kind, and they have character. And isn't that what we all want when it comes to love? We want a good man who's going to be good to us.
Absolutely. I totally agree. And we're going to pause right there because I have something else I want to share with you on that subject, Ms. Sheila. But my timer just went off. Take it out and let's check it.
Now, David.
Where can fans and everyone find your favorite recipes?
Well, like I said, I'm everywhere because I do enjoy eating and I do like sharing recipes with my readers. There's always a recipe of the month in my Sheila's Place, the newsletter you can sign up for on the Sheila's Place website. And on the website, we also have pages dedicated to recipes. And there are tons of them there because I've been doing this for quite a while. So if you scoot through the archives, you'll find all kinds of fabulous recipes, including one called Printen Parfait. Printen is a German cookie, kind of like Lebkuchen, and it gets crumbled into this thing that's got rum and whipped cream and all kinds of things that we don't want to eat right now while we're trying to lose weight. But maybe by next Christmas, we'll be ready, right? So anyway, but lots of fun recipes there. So just go to the recipe page and you'll find all kinds of goodies.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for sharing that with us, Ms. Sheila. It's time for us to dig into our baked shrimp and broccoli. Are you ready?
I am ready. Let me grab my plate here.
So we're just going to go ahead and just transfer our broccoli onto our plate like so. And you see the juice that's at the bottom of the foil?
Yes.
From your butter and from the chicken broth and from the olive oil, all that good stuff. Mm-hmm. Well, I'm going to show you what to do with that juice afterwards. And we're just going to go ahead and place our shrimp on the plate as well. That looks amazing. Great job, Sheila. Great job. Perfect. You have your parsley ready?
I do.
Awesome, awesome. And what we're going to do is just garnish our shrimp. If you prefer to put some parsley on your broccoli as well, feel free. I normally just do it on my shrimp. So we're just going to take a little bit of our parsley. And we just want to sprinkle a little bit on top of our shrimp.
Wow.
And voila.
Yummy. It looks so good.
It is. It absolutely is. This is our baked shrimp and broccoli. Now, let's dig in. Let's taste it.
Got my fork. I'm ready.
All right. Let's do it.
Oh my gosh.
Mm.
Oh my gosh.
Mm. Miss Sheila. What you think? See, I mean, what you think over there?
Mmm. Why? I'm gonna go eat now. Oh.
I love it. Oh my goodness. When I tell you this is absolutely delicious, and I'm trying to talk and eat at the same time, it's never a good match. But this is delicious. Sheila, I hope you enjoying it.
I did. Thank you so much for talking with my mouthful here.
And I know.
For spending time with me today. I really appreciate it. And I know readers are going to love this recipe. It is really fabulous.
Well, I definitely hope so. And thank you for joining us. It has been an absolute honor to interview you today. It's been wonderful.
Happy to be with the queen of the kitchen and happy to be enjoying our fun time with Harlequin. Something good to eat while you're reading a Harlequin book.
That's it. You can't put it no better way than that. So while we are eating, you have to tell me what you have coming up next.
Well, I'm very excited because we're going to the beach with Sunset on Moonlight Beach. And then come closer to Christmas, I'm going to be getting a little Christmas spirit. So I'm excited to have two books coming out with Harlequin this year. It's going to be a fun year, and I'm looking forward to it. And I hope readers will enjoy the books.
Wow, I am so excited. I can't wait to see them, hear about them, and read them. Thanks again, Sheila.
Thank you.
I would like to thank our guest, best-selling author Sheila Roberts, and for doing an amazing job on the baked shrimp and broccoli. And make sure you guys check out her latest release, Sunset on Moonlight Beach. And for this recipe and more, don't forget to click on the link below. Make sure to share and subscribe. Until next time, bye.